up guys? It's me again, Shirley, na laging nagsasabing, what you think is what you become. Ngayong araw na to ay napaka-special na araw sa akin kasi after 18 days guys, nagkaroon po tayo ng 100 subscriber at yun po ay dahil po sa pagsuporta ninyo sa akin. And thank you po talaga. At sa aking mga relatives, friends, family, cousin, thank you po ulit-ulit pa ako nagpapasalamat. At sa mga hindi pa nag-subscribe, baka gusto nyo pong mag-subscribe, click nyo po yung subscribe button, share-share na rin, like-like na rin, salamat! Okay, bago tayo lumayo, shout out muna kay Jonah Matereg. Ang ganda ng pinag-usapan natin kagabi, be. And I will share this vlog to you, share mo sa mga friends mo, and to Juan, Jeline, De La Cruz, Matereg. I love you! Mwah, mwah, mwah! At sa aking best friend sa Dubai, Angelina Bibi. Thank you po sa suporta. Sana huwag kang magsawa na mag-share-share ng ating vlog. And lastly, sa aking pinakamamahal na hubby, thank you po sa unending support. Love you! Our channel is more on educational information. Sometimes nag-a-upload ako ng tungkol ng visa, kung paano po mag-process ng visa, or kung ano po ang mga ganap dito sa Thailand. Pero more on educational information po sa mga education units at sa mga nagtiteacher po. Kung kayo ay naghahanap ng mga research o kayo ay kumukuha ng educational units, nagtiteacher po kayo, you come to the right channel po. Kasi lahat po ng inilalagay ko dito ay mga past activities namin at dumaan na po sa mga professor na check na nila, pwede po niyong pagbasihan. Okay guys, so today we will talk about The Mind is Like an Iceberg by Freud. Do you believe that our mind is like an iceberg? Yan po ang tutuklasin nyo. Then about defense mechanism. Why we're always having our defense mechanism? Bakit nga ba? Yan din ang tutuklasin nyo. Marami po kayo makikita sa loob, mga bakit tayo may mga ego, super ego, ID. Ang dami nyo po makikita. So, kayo na po ang bahala tumingin sa loob. Okay, kung hindi pa tayo nakapag-subscribe, kindly click po yung subscribe button. Like and share na rin para po sa mga kasama natin na naghahanap din ng mga research, ng mga activities nila, at least makapag-share tayo ng kahit kunting idea. At salamat po. Kita tayo po hanggang sa huli.
So question number one, what did Sigmund Freud mean when he said the mind is like an iceberg? When Freud supposedly said the mind is like an iceberg, it floats with 1/7 of its bulk above the water, he means that people repressed most of their thoughts, memories, and desires, especially those that are painful or socially unacceptable. According to David Morrison, certified educators, what Freud meant by this metaphor was that the human mind is more than just our consciousness. The consciousness is just the tip of the iceberg. So to speak, beneath the water, there's a lot more ice submerged. This ice is the metaphor for the subconscious, which Freud set out to explore in his work as a psychoanalysis. This is related to the question number one. According to Colin Cavendish-Jones, PhD, certified educator of Sigmund Freud analogy, between the mind and an iceberg is immediately clear. The greater part of the mind is hidden, and the only a small part is visible to both the other people and to the person whose mind it is. More precisely, Freud saw the mind as being composed of three labels. The top label, it is the conscious mind. Below, this is the preconscious mind. In the bulk, it is the unconscious mind. Lastly, according to Olin Rose, certified educator, Freud analogy referring to the importance of the unconscious in directing human behavior. Question number two is, how did Freud define the ID, ego, and superego? According to Sigmund Freud, human personality is complex and has more than a single component. In this famous psychoanalytic, Freud states that personality is composed of three elements. These are the following: the id, the ego, and the superego. So in this level, we will discuss the id, the ego, and the superego. First, we will discuss the id. According to Freud, the id is the source of all the psychic energy, making it in the primary component of personality. The id is the only component of the personality that is present from birth. The id is the aspect of personality. It is entirely unconscious and it includes instinctive and primitive behaviors. It is driven by the pleasure principles. In the id is the very important early in life because it ensures that the infant needs are met. And lastly, Freud compared that the id to the horse. To the next is the ego. According to Freud, the ego develops from the id and ensures that the impulse of the id can be expressed in the manner acceptable in the real world. The ego functions the conscious, preconscious, and unconscious mind. The ego is the component of the personality that is responsible for the dealing with reality. The ego operates based on the reality principles, which it strives to satisfy the id's desire in realistic and social appropriate ways. The ego eventually allows the behaviors, but only to the appropriate time and place. And Freud compares the ego to the horse rider. And lastly, the superego. According to Freud, the superego begins to emerge at around age 5. The superego holds the internalized moral standards and ideals that we acquire from our parents in society. It is our sense of right and wrong. The superego provides guidelines for making judgment. The superego tries to perfect and civilize our behavior. And the superego is present in the conscious, preconscious, and unconscious. Okay, question number 3. What, according to Freud, is the concept of defense mechanism and why it is important? Firstly, defense mechanisms are behaviors people use to separate themselves from unpleasant events, action, or thoughts. These psychological strategies may help people put distance between themselves and treat or unwanted feelings such as guilt or shame. The concept of defense by George Gero, MD, New York. Today, the conception of defense is extremely complex. It refers to the set of unconscious activities of the ego, which partake all the puzzling qualities of unconscious processes in which occur without any intentional effort. To clarify the idea of defense, it is helpful to consider certain dualism in psychoanalysis, of which there are several among others by sexuality, paired component impulse like sadism and masochism, in the active-passive of the dichotomy. Number 4 question. Why the defense mechanism is important? According to G.A. Valiant in Encyclopedia of Human Behavior, 2nd edition 2012, the defense mechanism can be positive ways to deal with stress. Other times, they can be unhelpful ways to avoid difficult emotions or excuse unhealthy or antisocial behavior. We use defense mechanism to protect ourselves feelings of anxiety or guilt, which arises because we feel threatened or because our id or super ego becomes too demanding. Defense mechanism can restore psychological homeostasis by ignoring or deflecting sudden increase in impulse, affect, and emotions. It can provide a mental timeout to adjust to sudden change in reality or self-image. Defense mechanism can mitigate sudden unresolvable conflict with important people living or dead. Finally, defense can mitigate conflict due to social learning or conscience. So number 5 question is about Freud 5 psychosexual stages of development. According to Kendra Cherry, medical reviewed by Steven Gans, MD updated November 19, 2020, during the 5 psychosexual stages, which are the oral, anal, phallic, latent, and genital stages, the erogenous zone associated with each stage serves as a source of pleasure. If these psychosexual stages are completed successfully, a healthy personality is the result. Okay, as you can see, these are the 5 stages of psychosexual development. At the age of 0 months to 2 years old, it is an oral development. They can find pleasure from the mouth, from sucking, biting, and swallowing. At the age of 2 to 4 years old, it is an anal development. They can find pleasure from the anus if they will defecate or retaining feces. At the age of 4 to 5 years old, it is the phallic development. They can find pleasure from genital. At the age of 6 or to puberty, it is a latency development. They can find pleasure from sexual urges and limited into hobbies in sports. So puberty onwards, it is a genital development. They can find pleasures from physical sexual changes, reawaken replaced needs, direct sexual feelings toward other leads to sexual gratification.
Okay guys, dito na po natatapos ang ating sharing for today. And I hope po nakapag-share ako ng kahit kunting idea sa inyo. At kung sakaling di pa kayo nakapag-subscribe, kindly click po yung subscribe button, like and share na rin pag may time. And hanggang sa muli po nating pagkikita, nasusunod na vlog po ulit. So, always remember, stay wonderful and always wear your smile. Lagi pong nakangiti para pumasaya ang mundo. So, till next vlog again. Bye-bye!
Okay guys, muntik na makalimutan. You can leave your question on the comment box below kung meron po kayong katanungan at sasagutin po natin. Hanggang sa muli. Bye-bye!